You have nowhere left to run, Eric.
Don't make me laugh. Say goodbye.
Miss Chambers, are you okay?
I think so, but I'm afraid it's too late. Eric's too strong.
It's not too late. I'll send you another piece of the story. Head there through the elevator, and I'll contact you afterwards. Hurry! This is strange, but you're in the right spot. The key in this tale is a golden pen. For the boy who lived here, that pen was everything. He made a special place in the barn to hide it. Find it.
Many years ago, there was a small boy who lived on a farm. His only companions were poverty and poor health. But the boy had something neither of these could touch, an incredible imagination. One day, while playing, he found a beautiful golden pen in the ground. He immediately knew it was a sign. He began writing marvelous stories with that pen, but the pen had a power he didn't know of.
Everything. Now you can use it to oppose him. Good luck.
I'm coming for you, Eric. I won't let you get away with this.
No, I'm meant to rule the worlds. It's my destiny. You can't stop me. This is the end for you. Impossible! What kind of power is that?
Finally over. Eric will never cast another spell again.
Murray, I finally understand. Taylor, Eric, me, everything here. Are we just a figment of your imagination?
No. It started out that way, but now you have your own will and desires. You're as free as me.
Real or not, this place is our home. I'll return the hearts to their stories. And make the tales whole again. After my incredible adventure, I understood everything. I had to mend Lightsville first, so the town's future sheriff could defend the law. Then, I had to return the shining object that created all of our words to the tale of Murray's childhood. Finally, the Night Owl is a faceless protector. She must remain anonymous. Now, my watch continues. After all, these are my worlds. I'll never let anything happen to them.